we are going to start a new chapter comparing quantity, UP. Now our next topic is percentage, which is another way of comparing quantity. Basically, percentages are numerators of fractions with denominator 100 and have been in comparing results. Let us try to understand in detail about it. First, meaning of percentage. Percent is derived from Latin word percentum, meaning per 100. To understand this, let us consider the following example. We made a table top of 100 different colored tiles. She counted yellow, green, red and blue tiles separately and filled the table below. Can you help her complete the table? The first one is color yellow. She used now 14 number of tiles. What will be the percentage? Rate per 100 is 14. That is, in the fraction form, we can write it as 14 upon 100. And it can be also written as 14% and red as 14% because the denominator part is 100. Similarly, for we have 26. So rate per 100 will be 26. Fraction 26 upon 100. It can be written as 26% and red as 26% and so on, you can find. Now converting fractional numbers to percentage when the denominator is not 100. Fractional numbers can have different denominators. To compare fractional numbers, we need a common denominator. We have seen that it is more convenient to compare if our denominator is 100. That is, we are converting the fractions to percentages. Let us try converting different fractional numbers to percentages. Let's take an example to elaborate. Out of 25 children in a class, 15 are girls. What is the percentage of girls? Solution: out of 25 children, there are 15 girls. So if we have to find the percentage of girls, we have to take the number of girls as the numerator. So which quantity it should be compared? Total number of students. So the denominator will be 25, and if we have to convert it into percentage, we have to multiply it with 100. So if we solve, we'll get 60%. There are 60% girls in the class. Now converting decimals to percentage. We have seen how fractions can be converted to percent. Let us now find how decimals can be converted into percent. For example, convert the given decimals to percent. The A part is 0.75. So to convert this decimal number into percentage, first to convert it into percentage, we have to multiply it with 100. 0.75 is multiplied with 100%. Now if we remove the decimal sign of 0.75, it should be written as 75 upon 100 into 100. So it will be equal to 75%. In the B part, 0.09 is equal to 0.09 into 100%. Now 0.09 can be written as 9 upon 100 into 100%. So it will be equal to 9%. Similarly, C part, 0.2 is equal to 0.2 into 100%. So it is equal to 2 upon 10 into 100%. So it is, when we solve it, it is equal to 20%. Now what if we have to convert percentages to fractions or decimals? We have so far converted fractions and decimal to percentages. We can also do the reverse. That is, given percent, we can convert them to decimal or fractions. Look at the table. Observe and complete it. I have solved 3 or 4 values for you. Like for the percent, fraction and decimal, we have 3 rows. First column is 1%. In the fraction form, if we remove the percentage sign, the denominator will be 100. So we'll write it as 1 upon 100. And for the decimal part, we have to put decimal sign before after 2 digits. So it will be 0.01. 10% can be written as 10 upon 100, which is equal to 1 upon 10. And if we write the decimal number of 10 upon 100 or 1 upon 10, it will be equal to 0.1. Now you can similarly fill for 25%, 90% and 150% and the rest of the blanks. In case of percentage, parts always add to give a whole. In the example of colored tile or for the height, we find that when we add the percentages, we get 100. All the parts that form the whole when added together gives the whole or 100. So if we are given one part, we can always find out the other part. Suppose 30% of a given number of students are boys. This means that if there were 100 students, 30 out of them would be boys and the remaining would be girls. Then girls would obviously be 100 minus 30%, which is equal to the 70. Now, basically, what is the use of percentage or how we interpret percentage? We saw how percentages were helpful in comparing. We have also learned to convert fraction numbers and decimals to percentage. Now, we shall learn how percentages can be used in real life. For this, we start with interpreting the following statement. Like 5% of the income is saved by Rav. 20% of Meera's dresses are blue in color. Rekha gets 10% on every book sold by her. What can you infer from each of these statements? By 5%, we mean 5 parts out of 100, or we write it as 5 upon 100. It means Ravi is saving rupees 5 out of every 100 that he earns. In the same way, we can interpret the rest of these statements given above.